Hello everyone. I'm just going to do a little HD wheel demonstration. Let me just adjust the camera a little bit more. There we go. And what this is, what you're looking at here, is a Groovy HD axle kit that I have incorporated in one of the wheels I use for my custom. And I'm using this as a demonstration, just to demonstrate to you the difference between a rag joint and the HD axle kit. Well, one of the biggest things about the HD axle kit is the bearings are sealed bearings, like a motorcycle style bearing, and they are not prone to wear out anywhere near as bad as the ones that you find in your regular bicycles. It's a completely different system. These are meant for long range and high speed and high heat. Bicycle ones are not. Okay, that is the number one major difference between this and bicycle axle hubs and axles. The next thing is the addition of the sprocket that attaches to the hub, and I'm going to see if I can bring that up nice and close so you can see. Well, the light isn't the greatest, but you can actually see in here, right where my finger is, where it actually attaches to the hub. It's attached to the hub. It is not attached to the spokes. This particular setup that you're looking at is with one of my custom made sprockets. I have them made specifically for Blow By You, or custom made to your order. This particular one is a 60 tooth sprocket. This was a prototype sprocket, and the reason that you're seeing the sprocket in the fashion that you're seeing it is because it's a prototype. The ones that I sell will have relief holes drilled in them all the way around, so they will look like an actual motorcycle sprocket. The next thing is they will also be reversible. They have an offset. It is a little bit difficult to see. I'm not sure that you'll be able to see that, but the sprocket is set off to one side. The sprockets that I send out will be reversible. If you want the sprocket to stick out more to this side, all you have to do is turn it over and you can do so. And this particular HD axle kit is a free wheel. When you go to Coast, the sprocket will, like all your chain and everything, will stop spinning when it goes to an idle, and you'll just be coasting. The advantage to that is that if you shut your engine down and you want to just pedal, there will be no parasitic drag, meaning the chain and the sprockets and all of that stuff will stop spinning and it will freewheel, and you will not have any extra drag except for just the extra weight of the engine kit added to your bicycle. The other type is the HD axle kit in the solid version, the only difference being that instead of bolting to a freewheel, it will bolt to this solid piece, and then you put the sprocket on and thread it on, and it stays on there solid. And the reason that you would have that is if you have a two-stroke and you do pedal start, you need to have this. The other reason that you might want to have a solid axle would be if you use an easy kit. They don't have a freewheel, so when you turn the throttle off, it will actually give you engine braking and slow you down when you shut the throttle off until you're down around 10 or 12 miles per hour. And you can do the same thing with the 4G kit. You can put a non-freewheel output shaft on the 4G, and if you go with an HD axle kit and a solid, it'll give you the same thing when you turn the throttle off. It'll give you, your engine will help slow you down until about 12 miles per hour, and then the clutch will disengage. This comes with this piece here. What happens is, if you need extra spacing, you can thread this on before or after, and get your you can have your sprocket spaced in or out more either way. Okay, so that is pretty much the Grubby HD axle kits explained. I'll just leave you with this. I think you can see what's going on right here. And I'm going to spin this sprocket, and you can see how true this sprocket spins, aside from me moving around. There is no side deflection. There is no up and down deflection. They run absolutely true. And these sprockets, along with this HD axle kit, and I know there's other stuff out on the market, but as far as I'm concerned, this is the best one on the market. It is not a piece that clamps on afterthought, that bolts through your spokes. This physically threads on to the hub, and it does not put pressure on your hub. It doesn't clamp, it can't slip, it can't slide. If you put this axle kit on there, you won't have any problems unless you wear out a freewheel. And if you go with a non-freewheel, it'll never be an issue. Okay, so I'll post this on the website. And thanks for watching. Blow By You. It's BLOWBY, the letter U.ca. Thanks for watching.